So you get green resources from most bases, blue from large bases, and purple from the center. Then you upgrade them in the outfit menu, and you go back to the vendor. Go back to the vendor to trade it in. And then whatever outfit bases you own give you resources per minute, but you only have so much storage space for your whole outfit, so you can't just stockpile a million bastions. You can only have, you know, so much weight for your entire outfit, meaning total Zerg fits, they'll probably have this full, but they'll still only have so much stuff. Okay, so I got some of the merit and loyalty rank from capping some bases, but you need to reach a threshold to be able to get the little freebie composite armor. I'm not sure what these prices obviously aren't final for PTS, but looks like you'll be able to buy Araxium and then you can just turn around and go up to your armory and upgrade the Araxium into the, I forget what this is called, Synthium and Polystellarite. Upgrade green and you can upgrade it to blue and upgrade it to purple and you can use it to craft everything. And these prices aren't final either, they said. I've already been around Sanctuary a little bit. Only problem on PTS right now is it seems like bastions aren't despawning properly and they're just all floating around. Other than the vendors, it's just a very, very fancy looking hangout spot. PTS issues, like, you know, TR Bastion just floating above the Haas and Warp gate eternally with no health. Still a few things to work out. You can't really walk on these. And this thing's technically supposed to be dead. So if it's moving, you can't actually be on it. It will cause problems to just slide away. No input. That's a major thing that probably won't really happen, but if this is stationary, you actually can walk around on it. I'm not sure how vehicle damage comes into play, like what infantry weapons can even actually damage these or not. What I actually wanted to test out was to see if something like the Archer or the Godsaw could actually damage a Bastion hardpoint. If that's the case, if you could catch one stationary, you could actually do a little bit of work. Maybe nobody would notice, because there's not going to be, like, there's going to be infantry defenders. There'll be planes. Okay. Apparently you can't orbital strike your own warp gate. Can I just pick, like, wherever? Can I just be like, fuck it. Orbital strike Nason's Defiance from the other side of the map? Really? That's insane. No range limit? Drop a tactical nuke anywhere I want? Yeah. Says it used it up. Able to craft an orbital on demand at any location at any time. Could create some interesting issues. So let's say I'm in this base. And I want to put a shield up on this base. I don't want anybody to be able to attack this aircraft, whatever. Let's just place it a health shield. Nobody can fire in. But you can fire out. Oh my god. That is gonna be a lot of pain. Supposedly the only weak spot is the very top of it. Which makes sense because nothing on the ground can really hit into it. Weak spot being a plane from above. Works out. Wonder, can you survive an orbital from this? I just said, okay.
Orbital strike authorized in your AO.
Drop an orbital on a Citadel shield and see what it does. That will actually destroy it. Not bad. Since I'm not in a squad and I think there's already bastions on the map that are currently bugged, can't really test that out, which is a slight sad day. And I think the test server just went down, actually, because my network ping has gone to infinity and I can't jump ship anymore. Okay, I actually lost all of my internet. Well, I guess that's an end then.